Hello there, all you beautiful thrill seekers. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to Ghost Chat YouTube channel. Hello there, guys. My name is Ghost Shadonk Stubborn, but built for theme parks, and welcome to a theme park newsroom update, bringing you the latest news on theme parks and attractions worldwide. Now, this is a museum. Update. This is a brand new update on a brand new museum opening in Derby. This is the brand new Museum of Making. We've got all the details via a Blue Loop article, which I've linked in the description down below, so please go and check it out. But yeah, today's been a very busy morning. I've had my Wrigley's Juicy Fruit, I'm tidy, I'm banging the celebrity juice, and I'm ready to go. But before we get started with all looking at all the details and sharing my thoughts on the brand new museum, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. Also, guys, make sure you go into the description down below where not only can you find the link to the article, but you can also find links to Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, and Snapchat. More ways to connect with Coaster Chell YouTube channel. Also, guys, you can submit your video ideas. Use the Google Forms link in the description down below. And for now, guys, let's have a look at all the details surrounding the brand new Museum of Making opening in Derby. So via the article from Blue Loop, the brand new £18 million Museum of Making in Derby aims to inspire future generations of makers, creators and innovators. Cited the world as the world's first factory, it also indicates how city centres might reinvent themselves post-COVID. Interest in crafts grew exponentially during 2020, and the new Museum of Making taps into this freshly discovered desire to make and mend. It will tell the story of 300 years of making in the Derwent Valley Mills, the world's first factory, now a UNESCO World Heritage Site. The new museum is located in the centre of Derby City on the site of the original silk mill. Now, the executive director of Derby Museums, Tony Butler, believes the museum is the attraction the UK didn't realise it needed until now. We are really keen on putting forward the idea that every young person can be a maker. This is when he was speaking to Jamie Doward of The Observer. He went on to say the challenges that we face in the 21st century, things like climate change and the environmental loss, much of that will be mitigated by the technology, engineering and ingenuity. And those are the kinds of makers we need in the future. The museum is at Derby's Silk Mill and as such embedded in its local. Nonetheless, Butler believes it will chime a chord globally. It's not just lads with beards in their sheds in Shoreditch tinkering with old bikes, he said. The whole creature of making resonates with someone, whether in San Francisco or London or Derby. Now, Borman Leon Architects designed the new building, drawing inspiration from the original Italian Arte Tower. However, Hannah Fox, the director of projects and programs at the Museum of Making, said the new building is a kind of mashup of lots of different periods. On arrival, visitors will walk through the 18th century Bakewell Gates, part of the original mill structure. As they walk into the Civic Hall, a soaring glass atrium, they'll see a Rolls-Royce Trent 1000 engine suspended from the ceiling. And unlike many museums, the Museum of Making will display its full collection of 50,000 objects. And these showcase items are from the Paleolithic past of the area right through Derby's industrial history to modern day exhibits. Now, Fox went on to say most museums have the majority of their collections in store, but this museum will have pretty much everything accessible to the public. They range from a huge engine donated by the Rolls-Royce to a fantastic little engine run by a single human hair that was showcased at the Chicago World Fair in the 1930s. The museum isn't just a place to look at exhibits, it encourages visitors to get a hand with making. Bespoke workshop spaces will let visitors try their hand at a host of different crafts. Expedition displays will also be created on site and can be sold to other museums. This will keep the original purpose of the building as a place of making. Now, the destination cafe and shop are also included in the design, and there will be a range of spaces for private hire. Expects to be used for a variety of business meetings, weddings, charity events and conferences. The opening of the Museum of Making ends a 5-year development programme supported by the National Lottery Heritage Fund, the Arts Council of England, Derby City Council and the D2N2 Local Enterprise Partnership. It started with a small amount of capital funding in 2015 and the local community has been involved in every stage of the development. The Museum of Making is slated to open this spring and is currently recruiting staff. this museum really is a taste of Derby history. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that is talking about the brand new Museum of Making in Derby, which is opening this spring, or projects to open this spring. Obviously, that opening date is subject to change, of course, with us going into the current lockdown situation. Of course, that's projected to end at the moment around the February half term mark, but of course, if things don't get better in this lockdown, then it will take longer, which means that spring opening is going to get pushed back until the summer. Now, obviously, you've seen the concept art and the drawings and the pictures on site flying about on your screen, a couple of images there flying about on your screen. And I'm a really big fan of this attraction. I think this is great. It's great to cover these attractions. You know, we don't just cover theme parks on this channel. We cover midway attractions, museums, water parks, safari parks and zoos. We cover all sorts of attractions. And, you know, it's nice to report on this particular new museum, because I think the whole gist of it and the whole sort of reason why they're doing this is, you know, amazing. It's nice to see that local Derby history coming out of this attraction, and it's good to see the old silk factory being transformed into this museum of making, keeping the craftsman-like hands-on interactive activity space as well as the actual museum part of the experience. And, you know, fair play to Derby and fair play to the National Lottery Heritage Fund and the council and the D2N2 local enterprise group. Everyone that's pitched in since 2015 to work on this project, that, you know, they've all been a massive help. And, you know, it's great to see that they're finally at a stage where they can start recruiting staff, get ready to open, hopefully if there's no lockdown through March and April, and, you know, it's not going to go through the spring as well, which we're hoping, all of us are hoping it's not the case. And I bet they're hoping it's not the case as well. They're hoping the cases go down with COVID so they can open this attraction in the spring, or project to open it in the spring. And they can keep recruiting staff until they get the opening date officially sorted with, you know, the latest government guidance, etc. So there's no doubt before the opening day they'll put in some temporary signs just to, you know, alert people to the guidelines and the restrictions to do with COVID in the attraction. Even if the cases do go down during this lockdown, there will still be restrictions until COVID is completely gone, in my opinion. But that's a whole other debate. But I think that overall, they'll put the restrictions in place when it opens, and I think that overall, this is going to be a nice, rich history experience and a nostalgia trip down memory lane for Derby's craftsman-like history. So there we go, guys. Thank you very, very much for watching this update on the Museum of Making in Derby. Projects to open this spring, but we'll see what happens, and I can't wait to see when this opens. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and for now, my name is Coast Shell, keep living the ghost life, and I'll see you guys in the next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Derby-tastic day.